Carl Jung was a Swiss psychoanalyst who created his own personality and psychology theories. He is well known for his theories on archetypes, which are universal patterns of behavior that exist across cultures, and the psyche, which comprises both the conscious and unconscious mind. In this video, we'll explore Jung's theories regarding the connection between creativity and the arts. We will begin by discussing Carl Jung and his contributions to psychology, and then we will go into how he believed art and creativity are linked to the psyche and the unconscious mind. You will have a greater grasp of how Jung perceived art and creativity by the end of this video, as well as how his concepts might be used to improve our own lives. Before moving forward, I would like to thank you for subscribing our channel and also for sharing your golden view on the psychology of art and creativity in the comments section of this video. Let's now delve in and explore Carl Jung's world as well as the psychology of creativity and the arts. In order to understand Jung's views on art and creativity, it's important to first understand his theory of personality. According to Jung, there are conscious and unconscious aspects of the human psyche. The portion of the mind that we are aware of and use to think and make decisions is known as the conscious mind. Contrarily, the unconscious mind is the portion of the mind that we are unaware of and which contains our most profound aspirations, fears, and memories. According to Jung, the unconscious mind is composed of archetypes, which are universally applicable behavioral patterns that exist in all human societies. The mother, the hero, and the orphan are a few examples of archetypes. These archetypes, according to Jung, are part of a collective unconscious that dates back to when apes and humans first evolved. The idea of the libido in Jung's theory is another crucial component. Unlike Sigmund Freud, who thought the libido was exclusively sexual energy, Jung thought the libido was a consequence of a generalized psychic energy. The reduction of inner and outward conflict is influenced by this psychological energy, as well as one's intellect, spirituality, and desire for pleasure. So, in summary, Jung's theory of personality is based on the ideas of archetypes and libido, as well as the idea that the psyche is made up of the conscious and unconscious mind. These concepts are essential to understand his views on art and creativity. In Jung's theory, art plays a significant role in helping individuals access and understand their unconscious mind. Jung believed that art is a medium through which individuals can express their unconscious mind and tap into the symbolic and metaphorical material that is stored in the unconscious mind. He believed that by understanding and expressing oneself through art, an individual can gain a deeper understanding of the psyche and the inner self. Jung believed that art has therapeutic value and that the act of creating art can be healing. He believed that art can help individuals to understand and express emotions that may be difficult to put into words. He also believed that art can be used as a way of exploring the unconscious mind and bringing forth new ideas and concepts. Jung also believed that art can be used to understand the archetypes that are present in the unconscious mind. He believed that by understanding these archetypes, individuals can gain a deeper understanding of themselves and the world around them. Jung saw art as a way to access and express the unconscious, and believed that the process of creating art can lead to psychological growth and self-discovery. Jung discusses the importance of symbols and archetypes in art, the autonomous nature of the creative drive, and the role of the artist and the audience in the creative process. Jung believed that symbols and archetypes are universal and can be found in all cultures and throughout history, and that they are an important part of the psyche. He believed that understanding and interpreting symbols and archetypes in art can provide insight into the unconscious mind and the individual's psychological state. Jung also believed that the creative drive is an autonomous process that is not under the control of the ego, but rather emerges from the unconscious. He saw art as a way to access and express the unconscious, and believed that the process of creating art can lead to psychological growth and self-discovery. Furthermore, Jung talks about the role of the artist and the audience in the creative process. He believed that the artist must be true to their own inner vision and not be swayed by external influences. He also believed that the audience must be open to the artist's message and not impose their own interpretations. Jung believed that the artist should be open to his unconscious, and the artwork should be a reflection of the artist's inner self. The audience, on the other hand, should also be open to the artist's message and not impose their own interpretations. Jung believed that creativity is a natural aspect of the human psyche and that the true purpose of his idea of the libido, psychic energy, is to act as a source of creativity and motivation for an individual. He believed that this psychic energy can be channeled into creative endeavors, such as art, music, writing, and scientific research. Jung believed that the creative process is a way to access the inner self and understand the psyche. He believed that by tapping into the symbolic and metaphorical material stored in the unconscious mind, individuals can develop a deeper understanding of themselves and the world around them. He also believed that by understanding the archetypes that are present in the unconscious mind, individuals can gain a deeper understanding of themselves and the world around them. Jung also believed that individuals should try to understand their own personal symbols. He believed that symbols are deeply meaningful and that by understanding these symbols, individuals can gain a deeper understanding of themselves. He believed that understanding personal symbols can be helpful in the creative process as it can bring new perspective and ideas. Jung emphasizes the importance of the unconscious in the creative process and the role of symbols and archetypes in art. Jung believed that the creative drive is an autonomous process that emerges from the unconscious, rather than being under the control of the ego. According to Jung, symbols and archetypes are universal and can be found in all cultures and throughout history. He believed that symbols and archetypes are an important part of the psyche and that understanding and interpreting them in art can provide insight into the unconscious mind and the individual's psychological state. Jung also believed that the artist must be true to their own inner vision and not be swayed by external influences. He saw the artist as a vessel through which the unconscious speaks, and that the artist must trust and follow their own inner guidance in order to create authentic and meaningful art. Jung also believed that the audience must be open to the artist's message and not impose their own interpretations. He saw the audience as a partner in the creative process and believed that the audience's receptivity is essential in order to fully appreciate and understand the artist's message. In conclusion, Carl Jung's ideas on art and creativity are an important contribution to the field of psychology. They provide a framework for understanding the creative process and can be applied to our own lives to help us access and understand our own unconscious mind. To channel psychic energy into creative endeavors and to develop a deeper understanding of ourselves and the world around us. Thank you for watching and we hope you enjoyed this video and already subscribed our channel. If not yet, do it now to see such an amazing content in the future.